Check this out. BJ Flores, the coach of Jake Paul, shared this, and it's true. I went to the Instagram. Ben Askren wrote, "Sorry, world," and Robinson responds to that, "Welcome to the club." So BJ Flores shared it. Ben Askren said, "Sorry, world." Nate Robinson, "Welcome to the club." And here's reactions from Michael Hunter, the boxing star.
Ben Askren just posted, "Sorry, world," and Nate Robinson responded, "Welcome to the club." Michael Hunter, you're a boxing star. What's your reaction?
I think that's hilarious. That's all I can say. I'm trying to find out if it's true. Yep. Oh, man.
I just checked. What do you think?
Nate, bro, get back in there. Maybe take the Askren fight, man. Redeem yourself.
That's
you got
right.
a chance.
That's
what,
right.
What do you want to see Jake Paul do next?
I like Jake Paul to fight a boxer.
Like who?
I think give him somebody that's man, that's a good question. That's the hardest question out here.
Yeah, Dylan Dennis, Connor.
Yeah, I think you can still stick with an MMA fighter for now.
McGregor maybe, right? If McGregor fights the money fight. Look, Jake Paul brings in money, man. So you got to have a guy that's a top-tier name.
Yep.
You have to have a name. But if you're a regular Joe, it's not going to happen because most of the boxing demographic that's following Jake Paul, they're looking for somebody that has that notoriety.
But there's no notoriety in boxing. This is a Mayweather or someone like that. Like
that's right. You have to be.
It's hard. Boxers are not as popular.
Yo, listen, I'm going to call this right, man. My man Tyrone Woodley. Get in there with Jake.
You like
man.
That, Tyrone Woodley?
Tyrone Woodley and Jake. Let's get it on.
That's a good fight.
Tyrone Woodley and Jake. I think.
You got a lot more hands than Ben. But.
Hey, can I ask you a professional question? They've announced Fury Joshua 1,000 times, and today they announced it 1,001 times, saying they agreed to the location, they agreed to the terms. Why don't they just announce the fight then?
I think that, you know, they're trying to get the people involved. They want the people to be excited about this fight because the people are in power. I think the people tell if the fight is going to happen or not, and I think that they're trying to get, they're basically telling live fibs, like trying to get the people involved. When, you know, the fight is really not happening, but they're trying to get it spoofed up so people can, you know, have debates about it and, you know, thinking that it's really going to happen. So
Andy Ruiz, May 1st, which fans, first fan cavalry fans against Chris Arreola?
Man, that's the StubHub right there?
You don't need referees. You don't need judges. They're going to swing until someone gets stopped.
Come on, Andy's about to cream him.
Andy wins, man.
Chris is in the best shape he's ever been.
Arreola got caught, bro, but Andy is a rare form. You can't compare him to Joshua, though. That you can't compare the second fight. I think Andy, when he's dedicated, Andy takes that. I'm going Andy knockout.
Yeah, me too.
Let's see what happens. Stay tuned. Will you be there, ringside?
Oh, when is that?
May 1st.
Yep.
Okay. You'll see Tyler there?
Yep.
Stay tuned.
Crime Faces might be in the building.
All right. Why Crime Faces?
Crime Faces, courage, respect, integrity, morals, and equality. We try to reverse the crime.
But okay. But you guys are famous and you have 100,000 followers on Instagram.
350,000.
Yeah, but it's really more. You can't, you know. Yeah, I get it. Because more people come and check out your shit without subscribing. But my question is, if you apply for a credential and they don't know who you are and they hear Crime Faces, they're thinking it's Catch a Predator.
Absolutely.
Or it's a crime show like First 48.
You know what? That's the perception.
Yeah.
When you hear that name, crime, but we're reversing the perception. We're working with fighters, gyms all over New York.
Nice.
Getting these kids out the streets and getting them in the gyms to really dedicate to the craft.
But he was on the table today with the talent.
Yeah,
I recognize the shirt. It stood up from the nosebleeds.
Absolutely. Oscar De La Hoya, Snuko, AC. See, look, he's already in the limelight.
Okay, he's doing his thing. We don't want to bother him.
You know,
he's good.
Just stay tuned, man, the things we're doing in this boxing world.
Stay tuned. Crime Faces. Elie Seckbach reporting.